Hello, Count Corvain.
Good afternoon.
How does Bruma fare lately?
Well enough, I suppose. The Great War mostly spared Bruma. Thank the Divines for that. Most of Cyrodiil didn't have such good fortune.
What can you tell me about Bruma?
Bruma is the jewel of the Jerall Mountains. A strong and hardy city. Imperial in name, but equally Nordic by blood. And while the county surrounding her is frosty, as Viscount Corvain says, the hearts of our people burn brighter than the warmest hearth. We have our share of problems, I won't deny that. But Bruma is a prosperous county given the times. Compared to Shadenhall and Breville, Bruma might as well be paradise. And at least we were spared the horrors of the Great War. Mostly.
Mostly. How did the Great War affect Bruma?
It didn't. Mostly. And thank the Divines for that. Of course, there were Dominion scouts roaming the Jerals on occasion, but that's to be expected. Minor skirmishes are not what people refer to when they speak of the horrors of the Great War, though. They mean the Battle of the Red Ring. They mean the sacking of Anvil. And these are evils that Bruma was spared. Her walls remain unharmed, and her buildings remain upright.
That
being said, Cyrodiil herself reels after the Great War, emotionally and psychologically. It took its toll on the whole province, and Bruma is no exception. Bruma may be spared the physical scars of the Great War, but the mental scars, they run just as deep here as they do anywhere.
Tell me about yourself.
I am Desilus Corvain. I have the singular honor of acting as Count of Bruma, defending her walls and ruling over her people. I am young, and I know some use this as ammunition with which to criticize me, but they are short-sighted, and they are foolish. I act in the best interest of Bruma at all times. I will always fight valiantly to defend her from threats both within and without. That is what matters.
What's it like being the Count of Bruma? You kind of already told me that, but...
It's a complicated task, let's put it that way. On the one hand, there are the Imperials. On the other, there are the Nords. And then, there are the other cultures to contend with as well. And I'd be remiss if I didn't mention that the Stormcloak Uprising in Skyrim has complicated things to a certain extent. But I'm proud to serve Bruma and her people.
Any other troubles facing the city?
Not particularly, no. I certainly don't envy my friends across the border in Skyrim, though.
No.
These are truly dark times for the Empire. Let us hope that this storm blows over, as of all the rest. But something makes me think this one's different. I fear Tamriel will never be the same again. If it's work you seek, speak with my Viscount, Marcius Corvain. He's more likely to have work for you than I. He spends most of his time in the castle.
Don't you spend most of your time in the castle?
Farewell.
Yeah, he gave me a bounty to, hand out, or carry out. Oh. Something tells me I want to stick around for this.
What?
This.
Oh, look, an infant. How quaint.
Don't make me miss you up. Are you guys here to talk to the Count? Just pretend I'm not here. Get a hold of yourself, will you? You're like continuously on speed. I really thought they were coming in to talk to him. Well, now they're just hanging around. You guys lost? Let me show you back to your homeland? With a well-placed fireball or two? Fireball? In your buttocks?
Hello.
It looks like they're heading over to talk to him.
Hmm?
You gonna wait till I'm no longer around or something? Alright, whatever. Castle Bruma discovered. I just left it.
Can I help you?
Nope. Certainly can't help me steal my goods from me. Steal my stolen goods. Oh god, the dog. I know I've been running for a while. This is where I didn't go up. The cathedral. Oh, chopping wood.
Finally tracked you down. Oh. You're not an easy person to get a hold of.
No?
I've got a delivery for you.
Do you?
Just give me a minute. Got to root around and, Here you go. I think that's about it. Right, I'd best be off.
What'd you give me?
Nope, sorry, nothing.
I remember that. Nope, sorry, nothing. Bounty decree? Well, maybe this is, I don't know if this is the one. No, this is the one the Count gave me. By decree of Count Docilus Corvain, let it be known to all upstanding citizens of Cyrodiil that the noble Count Docilus Corvain of County Bruma has placed an official bounty decree upon the bandits at Capstone Cave, whose activities harassing travelers, merchants, and good citizens of County Bruma must be put to an end. Appropriate payment shall be provided to any who slay the bandits' ringleader. Once the deed is done, report to the castle steward. Alright, anything else? I don't suppose they gave me this. Scald Jarl of Dawnstar to Amethyst Lunatari, his steadfast friend, grant of the steading of Helljarshin Hall, south of Fort Dunstad near Giant's Camp. Granted on 22nd Seed 203. This might be it? He certainly went a long way to give that to me. Lakeview Manor Charter? I hear this gets stuck like this. Dengir of Stun, Jarl of Falkreath to Amethyst Lunatari, his loyal friend, grant of the steading of Lakeview Manor on the south shore of Lake Ilanada, east of Falkreath. Witnessed by Tekla Stewart to the Jarl Yengir of Stun, 22nd Seed 203. That might be it, too. This, in case you guys are wondering... Silly. It doesn't even work anymore. I use this... This is part of a mod that I got, like, off of... It's the only mod I ever got off of the Steam Workshop, I think. It's, it helped me... kiss Carlia in the episode where I married her. Because I wanted to be able to do that. And yeah, after that, it kind of stopped working, so... Kind of fittingly. Request from Legate Varro. I'm trying to see what I haven't read. I hope this note reaches you in good health. Your service in dealing with the Stormcloak prisoner recently was much appreciated, and upon further reflection, I believe we have a long-standing problem that could use your unique touch. Oh, this must be it. Please report to me at Fort Pale Pass as soon as you can, and I'll brief you on the details. Legate Priscillius Varro. Okay. Yeah, that's gotta be the one. Yeah, alright, that's it. Report to Legate Priscilius Varro at Fort Palpas.
I'm Albecius, of the Jucani family.
Oh! Is he the one with the dog?
Yes, traveler. What do you need?
Tell me more about yourself. He doesn't want to say it's time.
I am privileged to enjoy quite a comfortable life. But I do try to give something back to the less fortunate folk when I can. The Great War took its toll on us. On all Cyrodiil. She may not look so different on the surface, but her spirit writhes in agony.
Tell me about the Jucani family. Isn't it the one with the kid? This is his dog behind me?
We're quite old, and quite influential. When we say things, people, important people, tend to listen.
E.F. Hutton?
That's not to say that we're the Elder Council, but we don't tend to be ignored either. That's not to say we don't pick up on new opportunities when we can, of course. Our family must always strive for bigger and better things. Not to sound like a priest of St. Martin.
Huh. Albecius Jucani.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Venus. Isn't it Venus Jucani? I'm not even sure. I didn't even have an option to talk to him about the...
Good afternoon.
Oh, Lassinia Iron-Heart.
What can I get you? What is it?
Are you Elena's mother? She asked me to find your husband.
Oh, that girl. I hope she hasn't been too much trouble.
No, no, not at all.
Yes, she's mine and Harran's. Well, used to be at any rate. Recently, she's just been mine.
What happened to your husband?
He was stationed at Fort Pale Pass, but we haven't heard anything for months. None of the soldiers passing through here on leave have seen him either. I've sent letter after letter, but they still haven't told me anything. I have no idea where he is, what happened to him, or if he's even still alive.
Have you tried to contact him directly?
Yes, many times. I've sent letter after letter, but heard nothing. I can send as many letters as I want, but if Harran isn't even at the fort... Then he's hardly going to see them, is he?
I could look for Harran.
You would? I'd be indebted to you if you did, stranger. Like I said, he is... was... garrisoned up at Fort Pale Pass. It's right on the border to Skyrim.
Okay.
Good luck. And please, stranger, I beg of you. Find my Harran.
Don't mind her. She likes to chop wood.
Good afternoon.
She's obviously distraught.
Talk to you later.
Jucani's house. Aren't they the ones with the dog? I kind of want to leave the dog here. Everyone's got this magic of dusk. I wonder if it seems kind of like a Twilight joke or something. Because I haven't read it yet. Now Carly is in my way. I cannot go. So noisy. So yeah, I have those books. Checked our basement. Cause why not? Look at all that meat. You can just stay here, dog, and eat the meat. Sweetie. Oh god. Alright. Okay, I kinda wanna finish looking around the city. Jucani house.
I'm proud of my ancestry, as should all Nords be.
Have I talked to you?
Just like old times.
How's business?
It's doing well. A lot of travelers tend to buy from me, as well as young Nords who are soul-searching, trying to find the Nordic heritage here in Cyrodiil.
Why are you here in Cyrodiil if you're so attached to Skyrim?
The same reason I sell ancient Nordic artifacts, so that the young Nords here in Bruma can be reminded of the roots. Bruma has all the surface trappings of Skyrim, the snow, the cold.
True.
But Skyrim is so much more than that. Something Bruma isn't and can never be. It's about the Nordic ruins dotting the landscape, about the dragon walls. It's about the diversity. Widerun and the Reach, the Pale and Eastmarch. That variation of Nordic culture is something Cyrodiil doesn't have. I'll be content if my presence here reminds just a few Nords that they're not just Imperials with more facial hair and deeper voices.
Be content. That's, content. So why do you sell ancient Nordic artifacts?
Why not?
What'd you say?
Why not?
It's something you don't see very often?
The same reason I sell ancient Nordic artifacts. So that Bruma has... It's about that fairy. I'll be content if my presence here reminds Jeff. Why not?
It's something you don't see very often.
Why not?
And I think they're...
The same reason I
saw... Oh, God.
Bruma. It's about that fairy.
Keep clicking the wrong one.
If my presence here reminds Jeff. Why not?
There are plenty of Nords here.
Why not?
In Bruma.
Why not?
Who'd like a little memento of their history, something like that.
Talk to you later.
Okay, I haven't gone in here.
What is it?
I'm trying to go inside.
Goodbye.
Yep. It was annoying talking to her.
What does this one mean?
Can I help you?
What do you do here?
Farewell.
Can I help you?
Oh, Dark Tongue. I was supposed to talk to him.
How may little Dark Tacto help a big one such as yourself?
The sinew de Vosmer love.
Renod, you're distressing the customers.
Distressing? I am distressing the customers!
That's what I just said, yes.
You dare! How dare you! I am outraged! You hire me to play songs in this bar that is so far below my standards, and now you proclaim my music as distressful! I'm done with you, standards! And I'm done with this shoddy excuse for a tavern! I'm off for the Restful Watchman, your top competition. How about that, huh? And you talentless, tasteless fiends! How dare you insult my music? Could you do better?
Probably.
No, you couldn't. Because I was trained at the Bots College in Solitude. And I'm the foremost practitioner of the art of song since Wagner himself. You are nothing more than jealous maggots, grasping your waist to insult me and belittle my talent. And to that, I say, good day!
Hey, I was just looking down in the cellar. We're out of greenwood mead, still, it looks like. We've been out for a week now. What's going on?
I wrote the order up ages ago, but I can't track down our courier. As soon as we get someone to deliver it,
he's
the
gone.
Mead should start flowing again.
I see. Well, let's hope the courier turns up sooner rather than later.
Well, she's in here, huh? Look who that was talking, like it's not her.
Come, warm yourself by the hearth.
What is it?
Are you the same Stone-Hearth I talked to? I think so.
Can I help you?
Nope.
Until next time.
Hello.
Oh, you owe some money.
Can I help you?
I'm here to collect payment for Razada.
Ah, yes. The enchanted horse hay he sold me. What a joke. The only thing magical about the hay was that it caught on fire very easily. My horses clippity-clop over it, and boom, it goes up in smoke. Nearly burnt down my stable.
Yeah, spare me the sob story. What about the coin?
Well, I managed to get some use out of it as a way of getting rid of pests. Pretty fun to use, too. But he did still swindle me. Here, take the coin back to Razada, but tell him to check that his enchanted items actually do what they say they do next time.
What is it?
Yeah, I'll leave out that part. The dog's pushing
me. I sell the finest horses in Bruma. Well, the only horses in Bruma, but nevertheless, the finest.
Cerendil?
What is it?
It's Cerendil.
Hello.
Bentior wants you to drop the charges.
Ha! That isn't going to happen, I'm afraid.
What's your problem with the Restful Watchman?
It's a dingy squad filled with criminals, rats, and lice. The amount of underhanded deals and crooked business that goes on there, it beggars belief!
So don't go there.
I want its proprietor to land in hot water with our dear guard captain. He deserves it, no? Say, would you help me with that?
Why exactly should I help you?
You should help me because the tavern is filled with criminals. They deal with bandits. They steal. They rob. Surely it's only right that they face justice for what they do?
Ultra,
not my thing, sorry. I'm trying to help the guy.
I'm not used to being refused. But so be it.
Deal with it.
Today it was the linens. Yesterday it was the... That isn't going to happen, I'm afraid.
It feels like you don't trust me.
All right.
I
see you.
I'm sorry, love.
Hi.
Stenar Ceno at your service. I'm no Nord. I'll keep drinking mead until I become one.
How dare you allow that visitor to engage in such a salacious display? Scandalous!
Hail, traveler!
Hi.
One of these days, though, I'd like to take a vacation. To the Highlands, perhaps.
What is it?
High Rock.
I could tolerate High Rock.
There's a lot of people talking.
What is it? Hello?
Are you an adventurer?
Well, I would be, but unfortunately I've got some debts to pay off. I've been doing odd jobs around town to help raise the septums.
What kind of debts?
Sorry, lass. That's something a man like me keeps private.
Ah. Oh well.
Bye.
Boy.
Hey, watch it.